My name's Karl Smith. I'm the owner of Access Technology, which is an assistive technology company here in Utah. I sell all kinds of products, including the ones we're going to show here, but also a lot of other ones. Today what we have are three different products for different purposes. The first one I'm going to show you is this one. This is called the Lyriq, L-Y-R-I-Q. It is a portable, very easy to use OCR product. OCR means optical character recognition. And it's designed for people who can't see at all, or maybe have really low vision, and so they have a really hard time reading print. It's designed to be very simple to be used, and but also give you the information that you want to know. I'm going to show you that it starts off this way. It's folded down. If I have to flip this up, then I'll turn it on, pressing the power button here. Now, normally you would only do this first time of the day. If you were going to use this a lot, you would not turn it off and on all the time. If you lower the camera, it will go to sleep, but it will stay. You flip it back up and it wakes back up again. Okay, this is a document that I'm going to place on the scanner. You should notice I'm putting it in landscape, because if you put it the other way, it'll hang off the front here. So I'm just going to lay it down and take my hands away.
Humanware. Humanware USA Incorporated. One Ups Way BO. Box 800 Champlain. NY 12919 minus.
Now, did you notice it said One Ups Way? It said that because, and this again is a characteristic of OCR, I happen to know it's UPS Way, but sometimes the synthesizer doesn't realize that, because speech synthesizer has to look at text as it comes in, depending on if it's all run together, if it's capitalized or whatever. And so you sometimes hear things like that, Ups Way, and you kind of have to get used to it. On my other piece of paper, there is an address, and it says my address is 4304 South El Camino, Saint Taylorsville, Utah. That's because it's ST period. And it says Saint. The speech synthesizer is the one that figures that out. So you'll hear that sort of thing when you do OCR. You'll notice those kind of things, and you get used to that after a while, and you just know that it meant street. So this button here on the right,
incorporated, One Ups Way PO Box 800,
stops and starts it just like it does off this keyboard.
100 Champlain, NY 129.
This button over here,
minus 4,500 top of page,
goes back, moves this back. Depending on how I see, I think it's
Humanware USA Incorporated, One Ups Way PO Box 800 Champlain.
And the other thing you can do with this button, if you press and hold this button,
battery 100%.
It gives me the battery level. If I press, this is a little tricky, if I press this button, and on the right hand side of the machine here, we have the arrow up and an arrow down. That's speed.
Speech speed increased. Speech speed increased.
I go down.
Speech speed decreased. Speech speed decreased. Speech speed decreased.
But if I press this button right here with the up arrow at the same time.
Main menu. Bluetooth.
Now I'm on the main menu in the machine, and I can use the arrow keys here on the right side.
Language. Options. About. Exit. About. Options. Language. Bluetooth.
So I can configure things. Like I said, I can connect this to a Bluetooth speaker if I want. I can change language if I want. Some of that's available on the keyboard already, but.
Language, options,
I can,
about.
I can, if I hit the about here, what I'll get is the serial number and the model number and the software version, all that sort of thing.
Exit.
And if I want to get out of it.
Exiting menu.
Just press that button there.
What I can do here, I have this keyboard that comes with this, that gives you some more, a little bit easier control.
And it has controls on it which allow you to change and utilize the material that you have scanned. This center button right here is the start and stop button.
One Ups Way PO Box 800 Champlain, NY.
The arrow keys, the up and down arrow, change the distance that you will move if you want to move through the document. If I up arrow here.
By character.
It says character. So now I can use the right and left arrow to actually listen.
One, two, 9, 1, 9.
Each character. If I go up again.
By paragraph.
Now it says by paragraph. And that's a little bit iffy because I'm not sure how it would define a paragraph in this.
Humanware USA Incorporated, One Ups Way, PO Box Purchase Order No. HWOP, remit to Humanware USA Incorporated.
I'm just jumping.
Box 71117, Chicago, IL 16069-4-1107.
I don't know for sure how it defines that. It depends on, it's probably line breaks or whatever. I'm not sure what it did, but it did jump through there. Now, if I go up again.
By sentence.
This is by sentence. Now, that normally in this document is probably not going to be real good because normally what it watches for is a period or a question mark or something like that and reads the sentence as you move along.
PO Box 71117, Chicago, IL 1606, FGEX 1016-3040, salesperson Kevin Hughes.
So I'm not sure how it defined that as a sentence, but it did. I'll go another up.
By word.
Now I'm back to word again.
By sentence.
By sentence.
By word. By character.
Here's character. So this is a stop and start button. If I go down here, this button on the right below the left arrow is the language button or speech. It changes the speech language.
Voice is set to English. Samantha.
And then press it again.
La voz está configurada para English. Angelica.
That's Spanish, I guess. Hit it again.
Voice is set to English.
I'm back
Nathan.
Here. Now, one thing you can also do, if you press this button, which is below the right arrow key.
Capital H, capital U, capital G, capital H, capital E, capital S.
It's spelling the word that we're on. And notice it says capital to let you know that. This button right here, which is between the other two, is the help button. If I press and hold this button and then hit another key.
Lyriq allows you to easily read when up arrow button is pressed. Lyriq will change the item. Item may be character, word, sent. When left arrow button is pressed, Lyriq will read a previous item. Press arrow up or arrow down key to select an item.
So as long as I'm holding that button down, then if I press a key, it tells me what that key does.
When pause resume button is pressed, Lyriq will pause reading. When it is pressed again, Lyriq will resume reading.
Okay. And then these two buttons on the bottom, on the left side is a vertical line, on the right side is a horizontal line. If I want to save the page that I have just taken a picture of, I press and I hold the vertical line button down, and then each of the arrow keys points to a different place in the storage on the machine. So if I press the left arrow,
page saved.
It just saved that page, so now I can take it away.
Please place your document.
And if I want to bring it back, I press the key with the horizontal line on it, hold it down, and press the left arrow.
Reading saved page.
And it brings it back in.
Humanware USA Incorporated.
And there it is.
1F Sway PO, Box 800.
And that's the keys.
If, in fact, you want to scan something larger, you can put a USB thumb drive into the USB port over here, and then every time you scan a page, it will just save it in there, and you could save a 500-page book if you wanted to. And then it would export it, and you could take it on your computer, and you could use it in your computer if you wanted to. I want to listen a little bit here and see.
1-800-331-0500. Please refer to our return policy of app comrades. Politica Data Evolutions, part of Optum.
Now, did you hear it say, did you understand what that website was?
No.
You did? Good. I think it's AT&T Returns or something. When you do OCR, one of the things that happens, and this is why I think it's really important for people to understand, when you do OCR, there are times, and this has actually done a pretty good job right now, so it's hard to show this, it will make errors. Sometimes if you hear, for example, you'll hear it read along and suddenly it says II. And what you think, well, what the heck is that? Well, what that usually means is that the font of the print you're reading has fairly thick verticals on the left and right, and then the line that goes across the small N is very thin. You see fonts like that. And if for some reason the printing isn't as good or the somehow it misses that, then it just sees those two verticals and it translates them to II. When you do OCR, there's two steps. The first step you heard when the camera took the picture. Then the computer has to look at that picture and determine what is a letter. And is this a letter or is this a number? and then it has to figure out which one it is. And so there's quite a bit of processing going on in there. It's much faster than it used to be, and it's much more accurate than it used to be. But this is really this machine is really used or designed for seniors or others who just want to read documents. They don't want to use a fancy computer and all that sort of thing. The price for this machine today, as of February 18th, is $1,995, I should say. And if you, you know, it's a great machine for use in a home or even in an office, but it depends on what your needs are. You can plug a headphone into it, or you can use Bluetooth headphones if you choose, so you don't have everybody listening to what your document says. So it gives you privacy there as well.
So tell me the difference between this and seeing AI.
Well, here's the difference. In you know, there are some people who are just fine with a program like seeing AI. It will do OCR, it will recognize currency, it does other things. The problem that you run into, and you'll see this, well, two things. First of all, the camera on an iPhone or an iPad is not in the center. It's up in the right-hand corner as you're looking at the phone. And so it can be a little tricky to get the document aligned and so forth for it to see it. The other major thing that you have with a iPhone app is that it has to have an internet connection in order for that to work. Because what it does is it sees the image, then it sends it off to a server somewhere, and it comes back recognized. Now you may not notice it because it's pretty fast, but if you don't have an internet connection, and this can happen like if you're inside a store, like in Costco, for example, I've been there and I can't even make a cellular call out of there because sometimes you get in the middle of that place and you can't get any connection. So you could not use seeing AI in that situation. It's also not particularly conducive to scanning large things. Like if you wanted to do a 500 page book, imagine trying to figure out how to hold your phone or build something to put that book in there, you know, to keep track of exactly where you are. That would be difficult. So, you know, it's certainly a good app. I have it on my iPhone. I've used it. But this product is really designed, again, for people who may or may not even use iPhones and don't necessarily have, aren't necessarily interested in trying to scan large things with a phone, or they may be somewhere where you can't use internet. I've got some customers at times who have gotten products, but the company, for example, will not allow them to connect up to internet in there. And so you have to have the ability to do things without the internet.
Hi, my name is Everett Bacon. I am the Assistive Technology Specialist here at the Division of Services for the Blind and Low Vision. You just saw a bunch of great products demonstrated by Karl Smith with Access Technology. And he said he would come to your home, and that's a wonderful thing. But if you would like maybe a little bit longer demonstration, maybe you're a vocational rehabilitation client or some other area that you need assistance at, we can definitely show you all of those products that Karl demonstrated today and a whole lot more. And we're here at the Division of Services for the Blind, located in Salt Lake City, Utah. You can reach me at ebacon, E-B-A-C-O-N, at utah.gov, or you can call me at 801-323-4343.
My name is Karl Smith. I am the owner-operator of Access Technology, which is an assistive technology company here in Salt Lake City. I have been doing this for 30 years, and I have various types of equipment for people with low vision or people with no vision at all. I sell various kinds of hardware and software. I deal with video magnifiers for people who have low vision, OCR products or optical character products for people who have no vision or prefer to have something read out loud to them. I also deal in Braille products. We have Braille displays which you can use to read material in Braille with, or connect to your computer or iPhone and run your computer or iPhone with a keyboard and a Braille display so you can see what's written on the screen. I prefer to connect up with people and come out to wherever they are and show them products that they're interested in, because I think especially if we're at your home and you want to see things, I say this way you have everything you want to look at right there. And it's also a good way to find out for sure if you're, particularly if you're looking at a video magnifier, where are you going to put it? Because if you put it in a place, for example, where you're looking straight into a bright window, it may make it difficult for you to read because your eyes are seeing this window. On the other hand, you don't want it, the window directly behind you either, because it could also reflect off the screen, and that may make it difficult. And so if we're in your home or workplace, we can see where you would put this and make sure it works the best. So that's what I do. I've been doing it for, like I said, 30 years, and I am available for anybody to have, who has questions or wants to talk to me. I'm happy to do that. You can contact me at 866-824-7885. That's a toll-free number that will connect to whatever phone I happen to have it tied to at the moment. It'll either ring my mobile or my office or wherever. And if I'm not there, you can leave a message and I can call you back. You can also reach me at Karl, K-A-R-L, at AccessTech, which is A-X-I-S-T-E-C-H.net.